from all over the world.
亲爱的法友们，来自世界各地的朋友们。
This is Wisdom Compassion Dharma University, and we are live streaming the ninth global Dharma teaching given by our respected teacher, Kenpo Sodaji Rinpoche. Today, Kenpo Rinpoche will talk about what makes a path or a philosophy the authentic Buddha Dharma. In other words, what is the four Dharma seals that distinguish the Buddha Dharma from other philosophies?
这里是智悲弘法大学，我们正在直播索达吉堪布仁波切的第九次全球开示。今天仁波切将为我们讲解什么是真正的佛法，也就是能够将佛法区别于其他哲学或修道体系的四法印的内容。
In the outgoing year of 2015, we have seen or experienced many joyful things and sad things that happen in this world.It is more like a movie, just like we are also inside the movie, going through ups and downs in every single day, with hope, fear, love, compassion, gain and loss, numerous schedules and plans, as well as sort of uncertainty and chaos.
在即将过去的2015年，我们目睹或经历了发生在世界上的许许多多的事情，有喜，有悲。就像是在看一场电影，只是我们也身在其中，每一天都感受着生命的起伏，经历着种种的得失，这当中既有希望、恐惧，也有爱与慈悲，有数不清的计划和安排，也多少会有一些混乱和不确定。
So, at the end of this year, maybe we can stop for a moment, take deep breath, and examine this world around us.Whether there is certain law or way out behind all these complicated and frustrating phenomena.
所以临近岁末，我们不妨停下来，再一次审视我们的周围，在这些纷繁复杂又让人沮丧的现象背后，有没有一个规律以及出路？
More than 2,500 years ago, while enjoying the luxury of his magnificent palace, the prince Siddhartha, for the first time, saw a man bent with old age when he went out of the palace from the eastern gate for a tour. And then, living by the southern gate, he came across a person afflicted with sickness. And living by the western gate, he encountered a funeral procession. These sights troubled and alarmed Siddhartha.He was thus determined to find a way to end these sufferings of old age, sickness, and death. So he left his family and palace life and started a wandering ascetic life.
2500多年前，悉达多太子正享受着王宫里的妙遇。在一次出游时，他经过皇城的东门，见到了一位与履而行的老人，又经过皇城的南门，见到了一位被重疾折磨的病人。当他经过西门，遇上了一场亡者的葬礼，他对这些现象感到深深的恐惧和不安。最终，他决定离开王宫，去寻找一条能够解脱生老病死的修行之路。他放弃了王子的身份，过上了一种居无定所的苦行生活。
Some may wonder what Siddhartha saw was quite normal to us, but why he was so much shocked?And then decided to seek liberation and freedom. Why do we feel okay with this suffering? It is pretty much because we never think they may implicate a deep-seated truth that exists in the midst of all these deluded phenomena. But due to his incredible merits, Siddhartha had a strong conviction that behind this there must be a way of liberation.Which could lead us to transcend the puzzles of all this phenomenon and wipe out these sufferings radically.
一些人也许会觉得奇怪，这些在我们看来平淡无奇的事情，为什么会深深地触动悉达多，让他走上了修行之路？为什么我们没有被触动呢？也许是因为我们从没有想过，在这些迷乱现象之中，其实蕴含着一个更深刻的事实。然而。由于他不可思议的福报，悉达多十分坚定地相信，这背后必然存在着一种解脱之路，能够引导我们超越种种现象的迷惑，彻底断除这些痛苦。
So, after more than 2,500 years being passed, what Siddhartha left to this world is still continuously inspiring numerous people. As he said, all compounded things are impermanent. All emotions are painful. All phenomena are empty. Nirvana is true peace.
因此2500多年过去了。悉达多留给这个世界的正法仍然在持续不断地启发和鼓舞着许许多多的人。正如他所说的，诸行无常，有漏皆苦，诸法无我，涅槃寂静。
All his teachings are never separated from these four Dharma seals. If a path or a philosophy contains these four seals, it would be Buddhism. Otherwise,Even if it was called Buddhism, it would just become a religious dogma and would have lost the whole essence of Buddhism.
他的一切教法都离不开这四法印。如果修行中包含着四法印，那就可以说是佛教真正的修行。相反，没有了四法印的摄持，即使名称上称为佛教，那也只是沦为宗教的教条而已，而丧失了佛教的真正内涵。
So, it is our great pleasure to have Kenpo Sotaji Rinpoche to give us a teaching on the four Dharma seals titled The Truth That Transcends All Phenomena. We hope that with his teaching, we are more inspired to embrace the unchangeable truth in this changing world and will generally follow the path of the Buddha towards enlightenment. Before he starts, let's chant some prayers.
今天我们感到非常欢喜，索达基堪布仁波切将在此为我们开示四法印的真正含义，题目叫做超越现象的真理。希望通过今天的开示，我们能够更加开放地接纳这个无常千变的世界中存在着的永恒不变的真理，能够更加真诚地追随佛陀的证悟之道。在堪布开始之前，我们首先进行念诵。
Om Namo Buddhaya 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 Om Om Mani Sohaya Om Nam Zile Nandar Lami Lam Zibu Zashi Shom Chi Yana Ye Baye Sam Chi Chom Da Ki Do Ban Bu Su Ken La Shem Tsa Tam Chi Zashi Shom Zom Mi Chan Bu Shen Tan Tum Zi Kwa Shin Bu Chi Hwa Ki Chai Wan Tan Ba Ken La Kun Ba Chi Chi Zi Ba Chi Long Bu Tan Ba Chi Chi Huan Tung Nen Sun Chi Tan Chi Li Gu Chi Bu Hwa Yi Chan Chi Ba Chi Li Chi Hwa Tu Chan Chan Tu Bi Chan Chi Hwa Bi Hwa Tu Hwa Chi Ba Chi La Xiang Chai Lu向华云南欢的多节奏写的中国公布新不化上一娘不知马南巴士那归娘不把球跟得上我把肚脐把过了相同中国大马的子你马也想在难得在喜欢解救想去生活见了想在路能祈祷求自己是解救总觉我所以我该买了你早等到本次我迷惑莫奈家财我结果落得人气大穷阶级先成绩小弟将外求救阶级嘛可所有我真比患比我早期冷漠见了相残路
냥지 진보르도 님이죠. 존내는 뭐는 진보르가 되다. 바커다는 감산도 실마. 좀바 되지 잘라 기숑 설. 아. 今天 很高兴. 在这边弘法大学，也就是说， 我们在一个这样的世界里，这样的一个环境当中，大家见面，并且可以共同学习。Today,
I'm really very glad to have this opportunity for us to share with each other and in such wisdom and compassion, Dharma University. And in such circumstances, in such world, I'm really very glad.
今天是 2015年，12月6号，也就是说，这一年，即将结束，下一年呢，要即将开始，也是这样的一个比较特殊的，也是。很殊胜的日子。
And today is the December 6th, 2015, and this is the last month of this year. And today will end, and the next year would begin. And today's date is very auspicious and very special.
我们在座的各位呢？也可以终结过去的这一年，也可以 将来的我们的生命，有什么愿望，有什么希望，也可以现在做好各种准备。
And at this time, the audience present and all the audience on the internet, we could conclude what had happened during this year, the year of 2015, and we could also make some aspirations for our future life.
如果我们总结过去的这一年，其实每一个人的生命都在每一天当中不断的变化，也有一些巨大的变化，也有好的变化，也有不好的变化。
If we concluded what had happened during this year, and we would find that there are many changes in this year, and even in every day, there are some small changes, even some big revolutions, and some good changes and some bad changes.
从好的方面讲，很多人获得了不同的财富、地位，以及世间上的各种各样你所需要的一些向往的就各种不同的你要的一些包括你的名声啊等等，有很多好的获得。
And for some good aspects, and a lot of people may get their fortune, get the reputation, get some status, and also some different demands, which you want.
也很多人有不太好的一些，包括也失去了很多你的财富啊，你的生命啊，你的故乡啊，等等，有许多东西也有失去，从而产生巨大的痛苦沮丧。
And for some bad aspects, perhaps many people have lost their fortune, lost their lives, and leaving their homeland. And because of this change, they raised up a lot of sufferings, and maybe you become depressed.
从全球的一些状况看呢，失去财富的，包括今年前所未有的前所未有的一些这个股市的一些暴跌啊，很多人呢也出现倾家荡产。
And from the global view, we can see that a lot of people have lost their fortune, and during the event of the stock market disaster, a lot of people have lost all the fortune or all the money in their family.
失去生命的，从今年看来，譬如缅甸的山体滑坡当中也失去了很多人的生命，尼泊尔的地震，也死了许许多多的人，还有德国、俄罗斯的科技的这种失事，以及我们在世界上各个地方发生的交通事故啊，包括战争当中失去生命的，也是无可计数。
And for the aspects that some people have lost their lives, and there are many disasters like the landslide in the country Burma, and the earthquake in Nepal, and the air crashes in Germany and Russia, and there are many kinds of traffic accidents all over the world, and also some wars. And in this instance or in these disasters,there are many people lost their lives.
更重要的，我们人生存在这个世界上，需要自己的国家和国土。但是，像叙利亚的成千上万的人，他们因为战争的原因，失去了自己的国土，有几百万人已经无家可归，或者说是流离失所，前往到别的许许多多的国家去，开始当难民。其实我们人如果站在他们的角度，站在失去生命的人或者他的家属，站在我们战争当中的难民，或者说是正在处于战争当中的苦难的这些人们，那这个时候我们会感觉到，在这个世界上有许多非常复杂的，也有一些痛苦的因素。
And what is the most important is that we people, we need our homeland, we need our own country. But some people in Syria, there are about thousands of people or 10,000 of people because of the war. They left their homeland and moved to other countries. And they are regarded as the refugee in other countries. They have don't have their own homes. And if we can stand at their point, or we think we are them, and we would find that from the aspect of the wars, and there are many kinds of factors of sufferings and many complicated factors.
今天我们这里啊比较冷，零下多少度？我们藏地高原呢，现在我所处的地方应该有零下十多度。但是呢，我们心里还是很温暖。温暖的原因呢，都有一些归宿。
And today, it is very cold here, and in Tibet, it is about minus 10. But though it is very cold here, but we feel very warm because I have the home. I am here, and we are not homeless.
不管怎么样，我们人活在这个世界上，应该珍惜自己的生命。同时也应该珍惜别人的生命，我们要多多的帮助他人以及所有的这些众生。
Anyway, the people we are living, and we should high value our own lives and high value the other people's lives. And I think we should always helpothers and help all sentient beings.
怎么讲？我们要珍爱自己的生命或者他人的生命呢？其实，最重要的，保护生命、放生，还有。我们最近也在提倡吃素。
And what should we do to high value the lives of yourself and others? I think we should protect the lives of us. And the first one is that we could let the captive animals free, and we should keep the diet of vegetables.
为什么吃素呢？因为我们如果去吃肉，有很大的过失，而且，所谓的肉食，按照佛教的观点来讲， 故事非常大。佛陀，释迦牟尼佛在不同的经典当中也讲过，其实杀生者和吃肉者的过患呢，完全是相等的，因为杀生者实际上是为了金钱而杀的，而吃肉者呢，为了吃别的众生的身体而产生贪欲的，所以说，从佛教层面讲，吃肉的过失相当大。
And why should we keep the diet of vegetables? Because it is really harmful to all the sentient beings when we are eating the meat. And from the aspect of Buddhism, our Buddha Shakyamuni had mentioned in many sutras, what he mentioned is that killing the animals or we eating the meat, they are the same.Why they are the same? Why they are the same? Because when you are killing the animals, the purpose is the money, and when you are eating the meat, the purpose is to eating the lives or eating the body of other sentient beings. So, in the aspect of Buddhism, we think that it is really very harmful when you eating the meat.
从世间的健康学角度讲，吃素的人，他会长寿，会心情非常舒畅快乐，还有他在身体当中的高血压等许多疾病也不会产生，同时呢，我们从环境保护以及保护生命等很多方面来讲，其实素食主义是非常有意义的。
From the aspect of health in our world, keep the diet of vegetables is really very beneficial. And if you could eat only vegetables, you could live a long life and you would be very happy and there is no diseases. And I think it is very beneficial to the aspect of environment and it could protect the animals. So it is really beneficial to so many aspects.
我本人也很多年以来吃素，但今年通过各种因缘更加坚强我的信念，所以我也发愿终身吃素，希望我们很多人共同应该在终身一生当中不吃终身的血肉，这是不管是从健康学或者说从生命学或者是从宗教学等等很多方面来讲，对你们个人是非常非常有利的。
And in so many years, I have been a vegetarian, and so many causes and conditions combined together. This year, I made this firm decision that I would.Be a vegetarian in my whole life. So I hope that most of you or all of you would make this the same aspiration that to be a vegetarian for your whole life. No matter in the aspect of health or in the aspect of life and some religions, it is very beneficial for you.
接下来给大家简单讲一下超越现象的真理，也就是说释迦牟尼佛2500多年前给我们留下来的非常珍贵的教言，它就是一个真理。
And in the following I would give a brief introduction and the topicis the truth that transcends all the phenomena. 2,500 years ago, our Buddha, Shakyamuni, left us the precious teaching. It is the truth.
不管你有没有信仰，只要你懂得了这个四法音，我想，你的生活、你的工作、你的家庭，一定会是有非常大的意义。
And no matter you have a belief or not, the truth or the four Dharma seals is really beneficial to your work or to your job, to your family, and to other aspects. It is really beneficial.
通过认识四法印，也就是说，诸心无常，犹如借苦，诸法无我，涅槃寂静。那么这四个原则则理，实际上是它包含所有的佛法，也可以包含我们实践当中的所有的真理。
And when you have known or you have the notions of the four Dharma seals, and what is the Dharma seals? The first one is that all compounded things are impermanent, and the second one is that all emotions are painful, and the third one is that all phenomena are empty, and the fourth Dharma seal is that Nirvana is the true peace. And if you have recognized and or if you have known all these four Dharma seals, it is very important, it is the truth, and all the Buddha Dharma teachings can be included in the four Dharma seals.
诸法无常，诸心无常，犹如借苦，实际上它是相对的一种真理，而后面两者呢，是绝对的真理。所以我们在座的很多人，不管怎么样，在生活当中会经常现实中各种你的这种苦乐无常等等，那么这些都实际上很多年前佛陀用他的智慧也给我们留下了非常珍贵的语言。
The first two Dharma seals are the relative truth, and the second and the fourth Dharma truth is the ultimate truth. The third and the fourth Dharma seals are the ultimate truth. And in our life, there are really many sufferings and many happiness and many impermanence. But many years ago,Our Buddha Dharma have already left for us.
首先，跟大家讲一下什么是诸心无常，也就是说，我们现在世界上的所有的这些，包括我们所存在的世界，在世界上居住的这些人类，包括我们的地位、财富。人的相貌以及感情等等，这些都是无常的。
First, we would talk about the impermanence, and it is the first Dharma seal. And in our world, no matter the external world or some inside emotions or the human beings or some.Property and your appearance, they are all impermanent.
其实无常，说起来应该比较简单，而且我们的生活当中每时每刻，经常在发生。但很多人因为不懂得无常的道理，所以并没有发现它。
Actually, the impermanence is very simple, and it emerges or it happens in each second and it emerges in everywhere. But some people don't understand the rule of impermanence and they didn't find the impermanence.
比如我们世界上很多人有地位，但是短短的时间当中他失去了他的地位，包括我们家庭的地位、工作的地位，以及世界上有不同程度的你需要寻找的这些位置，但因为无常的原因，短短的时间当中他已经失去了。没有懂得无常的人也许非常伤心。
For example, a lot of people may have their own positions or status, but always they lost the status in such a short time, like the status in your family, the status in your company, or in the society. Just because of the impermanence, we lost the status in such a short time. But the people who didn't recognize or didn't understand the rule of impermanence, he may be very upset.
同样的，我们有些人的相貌在年轻的时候应该青春美满，非常端严无比，但是过了一段时间，过了几十年之后，就显得相貌丑陋，连自己都不想看，有些人很伤心。
And similarly, when you are a young person, you may have a good appearance, but after a period of time, maybe some years or some decades, the appearance is not as good as before. Maybe you will not see it in the mirror yourself. She is very sad or he is very sad.
同样的，我们世间的人与人之间的感情，有时候非常亲密无比，但是到一定的时候不但没有感觉，甚至呢非常仇恨，也不想见他，也不想听他的声音，这也是无常的原因。
And similarly, the emotions in our life is also impermanent. Sometimes we have a close relationship with others, but sometimes we may hate with each other. This is also because of the impermanence.
因为许多人不懂得无常，在生活当中发生各种无常的现象的时候，他们无法接受，甚至有些人无法面对而选择自杀。有些人即使没有自杀，但是留下很多很多的泪水，这个泪水很值钱的。
So a lot of people, they don't understand the truth of impermanence, and when impermanence emerge in their life, they don't want to adopt this impermanence. So some people take the activity of suicide, and if you didn't suicide, but there are about a lot of tears, and maybe this kind of tears would cost a lot of money.
有些人不懂得无常而流下的眼泪，如果全部积聚放在一个洗脸盆的话，可以洗脸，也可以刷牙，有很多的这种生活呢，以这个泪水也可以解决。
And there are some people, they don't understand the truth of impermanence, and so the result is a lot of tears. If the tears accumulated together, Rinpoche said that maybe the tears could be used to wash your face and brush your teeth.
因为无常，所以在生活当中发生各种不同变化的时候，如果我们真的了解无常的本意呢，它未必是个不好的事，也许 依靠发生这样的事情，对你的生活有着新的开端。
Just because of the impermanence, when something impermanent emerges in your life, if you have known the truth, it may not be something bad, it may be something good. It may give you another start or another beginning in your life.
因为我们的人生，人生的路可以有很多很多，所以有一条路如果做得不成功，也可以选择另一条。
There are many ways in one's lifespan. If you are not successful in this way, you could select or choose another way.
如果一个人失恋了，但是有些人就很伤心，其实不应该伤心，应该因为无常的原因，他没有这个机会，但是有更好的一些空间，有更好的机遇，也可以选择更美好的路。
And maybe some person, he breaks with his lover, and he would feel sad, but it is not necessary, and we don't have to feel sad. Just because of this impermanence, it is a great opportunity for us to find a new way, or find some new lover, and find a new opportunity for our future life.
如果我们懂得无常，其实它对生活很有帮助的。比如说，作为一个成功者，如果懂得无常，他不会很傲慢的。他知道我暂时的所谓的人们羡慕的这个成功呢，到一定的时候也不会长久的，它会有变化的。因此，他在这样的岗位上，他不会看不起别人，他有一定的心灵的这种修养。
If we understand the truth of impermanence, it is very beneficial to our life. For example, if you are very successful or you are in a good condition, you would not be arrogant, because of you know the truth that everything is impermanent.Just because you have this notion and you know that the success will not last for a long time, just because you have this notion, you will not look others down.
因为他懂得无常，如果在生活当中遇到逆境或者失败，他也不会特别沮丧，因为他知道暂时我生活处于一种非常糟糕或者是低落的这样的状态，但是因为无常的原因，他可以还有新的机会。因此我想懂得无常，不管是在生活上在修行上有非常意义。
And if you have understand the truth of impermanenceWhen you are in unfavored conditions, or when you are not successful, you failed, you will not feel depressed, or you will not feel much depressed, because you know that now you are in some bad situations, but this kind of situation is impermanent, so you have the chances to make this situation to be better. As a result, it is very beneficial for us to know the truth of impermanence, and it is very beneficial to our life and to the practicing in the Dharma.
在我的身边，不管是出家人、在家人，如果懂得无常，在他们的生活当中发生一些变化的时候呢，我听得最多的他们的笑声，他们重聚的。这是一个自然规律，没有什么了不起的，没有什么面对不了的。所以，不管是家里发生什么，或者说工作上发生什么， 大家都很开心的。
And for the people around me, no matter the renunciates or renunciants or some lay people, they know the truth of impermanence. When the impermanence emerges, what I hear is the love songs, because they know the truth and they don't have the attachments to the things around them, and they feel very happy when they are working and in their family.
同样在 我的身边，懂得无常的人，不懂得无常的人，不懂得无常的人，他在生活上发生一些变化的时候，比如说家人死了，或者说自己的这种就失败了，不成功，诸如此类的时候，经常就痛苦，而且呢哭得最多的哭声，我听到的哭声是最多的。
And similarly, the people around me, if they don't understand the truth of impermanence, and when some impermanence emerge in their life, for example, his friend or his relatives died, or he lost his job, or he failed in the life, he would take a lot of sufferings.In this time, what I heard is the sound of crying.
因此，总结，总而言之，也可以总结出这么一个，如果动得无常，我们在生活当中发生的一切事都是非常正常的。
Thus, we can give a conclusion that if you understand or if you have the notion of impermanence, everything in our life is very normal and it is very reasonable.
第二一个犹如借苦啊，犹如借苦呢，按照佛教的教义，以专业的术语讲呢，犹如是根据佛教的毗婆萨论当中所谓的犹如呢，是牛庆的意思，也就是说，依靠他让众生在色界、欲界、色界、无色界当中不能获得解脱，而一直扭住在这个三界当中的意思。
And in the second part, we will talk about the second Dhamma Seal, and the second Dhamma Seal is that.All emotions are painful. According to the Buddha Dhamma, and what is the meaning of the emotion? And the emotion or the contaminated emotion has the meaning of retaining. It would lead us or it would make us retain in the or make all the sentient beings retain in the three realms.And the three realms are the realm of desire, and the realm of form, and the realm of formlessness. And the emotion would lead us to the samsara and could not get the liberation.
所谓的犹如，也就是说，烦恼，贪心、嗔心、痴心。那么，所有依靠烦恼。而产生的法，或者说烦恼本性的这些呢，全是痛苦的。
And contaminated emotion also has the meaning of afflictions, and it includes the desires, hatred, and ignorance, and any other kinds of afflictions. All of theemotions or all of the afflictions are the causes of the suffering.
有些人认为佛教当中一切犹如借苦呢，实际上这是一个悲观的态度，或者说这种不合理的一种现象，因为我们实践当中很多的快乐 人为佛教的这种说法是一种效机或者是套比的，但实际上呢，它不是这样的，它就是我们人生的一个真理，人生的一个真实的现象。
Some people may think that in the Buddhism we mention the suffering and it is pessimistic, it is not reasonable, they think that all the Buddhists, they are negative, they want to escape all the happiness in our life. But actually, it is not something attitude, it is the truth. What we mention here is not the attitude.
佛教当中所说的人生苦多乐少，实际上这不是一个佛教的独特的观点，应该说我们在世界上的每一个人观察自己的一生，终结你的一生的时候，也许你的感受很深的。
And we say that there are more sufferings and there are less happiness in our life. We said it in the Buddha Dhammas or in some sutras, but it is not something special in Buddhism. It is the truth. When you could conclude or your whole life, you would feel it deeply.
我们每个人可以想一想我们人生当中有生老死病的痛苦，还有呢，有许许多多的现实当中的痛苦，最主要的呢，有苦苦、变苦、性苦。那么这些苦呢，也许我们每天都在感受。
When we conclude our life, there are many kinds of sufferings. For example, the birth, the aging, the sickness, and the death, and or any other kinds of sufferings in our real life. And in Buddhism, we could divide the sufferings into three main kinds. The first one is the suffering of suffering, and the second one is the suffering of change.And the third one is the pervasive suffering. These kinds of sufferings we could feel in every day.
譬如我们经常心情不舒服啊，身体不好啊，或者家人死了，再加上你的工作不顺利啊，等等，一个苦还没有消除的时候，另一个苦接踵而至，也就是说我们人生当中有些人好几层苦就压着他，有些人呢有部分的苦，所以这叫做苦苦，一个苦加上苦，这就是每个人不管是这个什么东方的人西方的人，世界上的很多人呢都有许多的痛苦，许多的压力。
And for example, in our life, we may in a bad mood, or there are some diseases in our body, or we have heard the bad news of people's dying, or we are not comfortable in our job or in our work.When we are taking one suffering, before the suffering has been eliminated, and another suffering occurred, so we would take a lot of sufferings. Maybe some people take some of them, and this is the suffering of suffering. Everyone, include the people in Eastern world and include the people in Western world, all of us could not escape from the sufferings.Or some such pressures.
所谓的变苦，实际上，我们现在感觉不到，感受一种快乐的生活，但它很有可能很快的时间当中都消失了。你原来的快乐马上变了，就变成一种痛苦，这就是变苦。
And what is the suffering of change? We may not feel the suffering of change at this very moment. Maybe now you are very happy, but this kind of happiness is impermanent. It may disappear in a short time, and the happiness becomes the suffering, and this is the suffering of change.
我最近看到一个美国心理学家的一个他这样的一个故事啊，有一个得抑郁症的人，他多年就跟自己的身体就还有这个心情都不好，就是得抑郁症。后来他可能有20多年的这种疾病，后来他发现他的丈夫呢有外遇，然后有更加的痛苦，但是不久呢他中了一个彩票，这个彩票2200多万美金啊。他当时得到以后原来是苦加苦，非常痛苦，后来这种痛苦马上变成一种很开心，然后他卖了一些很好的一些别墅房子，然后将自己的两个孩子送到一些特别好的一些私立学校，在这个时候呢他就感觉一种很快乐的生活，但是不久的将来重新又他的抑郁症又开始重发。所以从这个案例当中也发现苦苦，也发现变苦。
And yesterday, I have heard a story. The story is that there was, it is said by a psychologist in America, and there was a middle-aged woman who is very depressed, and this kind of depression lasts for about 20 years.And in these 20 years, she is in the bad mood, and she got a lot of diseases. And 3 years later, or some years later, she found that her husband had another woman. So she take another suffering. This is the suffering of suffering. And sometime later, he had won a lottery, and the lottery is about $22 million. She become very happy, and she buy a big house and send his children to the best schools. But some days later, or some months later, the depression emerged again, and this is the suffering of change.
还有一个叫辛苦啊，所谓的辛苦有两种意思，有一种意思我们今天享受的生活快乐，实际上我们看不到它的背后有许许多多的一些痛苦，譬如说一个人享受美餐，就吃很好的肉，就吃肉，但是你不知道这个肉的就失去了这个人这个终身的生命，所以这也是一种辛苦。或者说我今天吃肉那么觉得很不错的，但是原来你不知道从医学角度讲，不管是什么终身的人，鱼类也好，鸟类也好，还有其他终身的肉，其实它很容易引起癌症。为什么现在世界上有这么多人依靠因为癌症而死亡呢？实际上有很多医学家他们的一些观察和他们的一些研究知道是跟如此有非常密切的关系。
And the third kind of suffering is the pervasive suffering. The pervasive suffering has two kinds of meanings. The first one is thatyou may feel very happy in your life, but you cannot see the sufferings behind all these phenomena. For example, when you are eating the meat, behind this behavior, There are many lives are lost. There are many sufferings. And now we can see that behind the behavior of eating the meat, some scientists have discovered that the disease of cancer and other some kinds of diseases are caused by eating the meat. And so when you are eating the meat, you don't find or you can't see the sufferings behind this behavior.
我们如果懂到优乳解苦的道理呢，应该在生活当中非常有意义的，因为每个人他每天都向往的是一种快乐，一种永恒的幸福，可是我们得到的并不是快乐。如果我们提前已经知道在这个世界上苦相当多，而且人生当中呢都有方方面面的这种痛苦会来缠绕自己的身体，在这个时候即使你遇到了这些痛苦，你很有智慧，有办法，有一种解决的方法。
If we have known the second dhammasu or emotions are painful, it is very meaningful. And every day and everyone would want to be happy and they want happiness. They want the happiness last forever. But if we have understand the truth, what we gain or what we get is not some kind of happiness.And we know the truth that there are more sufferings and less happiness in our human life. Now we know that this kind of suffering would torture our body and our mind. So if we know the second Dhamma Seal, we have the wisdom and have the methods to deal with the problems.
我们如果住在一个高原上，天气特别冷。这个人明明知道我现在所处的地方是非常寒冷的，那在你的生活当中出现一些寒冷的状况，你觉得这是一个很自然的、很正常的。但如果你不懂得你处的一个寒冷的地方，即使有一点点的寒风借助你的身体，你都可能受不了。同样的道理，犹如借苦，我们每一个人应该要知道它的真相。
For example, if you live in the place where it is very cold, but even it is very cold, you feel it is very normal, it's reasonable, you would not take more sufferings. And if you don't know that it is reasonable, you think it is not reasonable, I should be in the place where it is very warm. Any kind of cold, you could not bear it. You would take a lot of sufferings. So, realizing or recognizing the truth is very important for us.
当然这些所有的痛苦的根源呢，实际上就是对我的执着而引起的。如果我们懂到我的不存在，我的空性，那这样的话，实际上所发生的许许多多的这些人间的痛苦、不幸、灾难，很多可以迎刃而解。
And all of the sufferings, the reasons of all of the sufferings is the self-grasping. If we know that every phenomena are empty, if we have the notion of emptiness, a lot of sufferings and or we can say all the sufferings and all the disasters on the earth could be eradicated.
下面讲第三个，诸法无我。
Next, we will talk about the third Dhamma Seal, All the phenomena are empty.
其实，我们每一个人认为是我是存在的。当然，我今天说我不存在的话，你们很多人会反对的。但用智慧来观察，确实，我们每一个人天天执着的我，也许找不到的。
Actually, everyone in their life, they think that the self does exist. But if I say that every phenomena, all the phenomena is empty and myself does not exist, you may deny. But if we use our wisdom to find or examine, does it really exist? We may find that we could not find the self.
不仅仅是所谓的我找不到，实际上我们所看见的这个世界也是一个假象，实际上它也不存在。
And the self, we could not find it. And even the world we see or the world we live is also not real.
伦敦大学有位教授，他经过多年的研究，然后写出了一本叫做《大脑如何创造这个现象上的世界》。
A professor in the University of London, he had published a book. Named How Our Brain Creates the Mental World.
这本书里面讲了一个道理，也就是说，我们现在感受的这个世界，包括一些独特的思想，人为感知的这个世界呢，实际上是不真实的。我们得到的信息是一个幻觉。
And what had found in this book, there is an important finding that the world we perceive or we receive, we live, and all the thoughts in our mind are not real. It is only something illusionary.
他们过来，这个外国人，你用英语说一下，过来到这儿。
There are some foreigners in our Dharma teaching. Welcome to you.
刚才我说的这本书里面介绍的是什么呢？就是说我们现在看见或者感知的这个世界呢，实际上并不是真实的，因为他认为通过五官塑造的这个外在的世界的真相，然后后来通过大脑当中不断的这个筛选，因为他接触的时候有一种电子信号，这种电子信号呢在传递到各种神经元，然后各种筛选之后呢最后传递给心识，那么心识所感知的时候，原来的整个世界呢有一定的变化，这个变化的来源呢实际上大脑创造的。
And what the book introduced for us is that the world we perceive is not real, and we perceive the information through our five sense organs, and the information had been transformed into some electric signals, and electric signals are stored or transferred by the neurons and transmitted into our brain. our brain would dispose this information or the electric signals and filter the electric signals. And at last, the results would be transferred to our consciousness. So what we perceive is not the same as the real, and it has been changed by our brain.
当然这本书当中主要讲通过大脑起到一定的作用，佛教不一定这样承认，但实际上有一个相同的地方，我们五官所感知的或者我们心识所感知的外在的这个世界，或者说是自身的自我呢，不一定是真实。虽然你去这样执着，你去这样认为，但是呢，也许你执着的或者是你所得到的这个东西呢，跟原来的它的本质有一定的差别。
Of course, this finding is some scientific finding, and this is not the same as what the Buddha tell us. And Buddhism may deny the scientific, but there is some in the same will. It is that the world we perceive with our five sense organs, or the world we perceive by our consciousness is not the real world. Maybe you have attachment on this, but from these findings and from what the Buddha said, or from the truth, we can see that there are some deviations or there are some differences between the world we perceive and the real world.
因此我们在这个世界当中，虽然是我们这样认为的，但是它不一定是真相。就像一个人他发现到黄昏的时候有一个毒蛇，但原来不是毒蛇，你一个人发现就是它是黑色和白色搓成一条线的这么一个各种颜色的绳索。所以当我们真正是认识它的真相的时候，离开了很多的恐惧和痛苦。
From these findings, we can see that what we thought is maybe not the truth. There's a famous story about the snakes and a rope with black and white and some other different colors. I think that most of people have already know the story. And when we have realized the truth, when we have know the truth, we could eliminate all kinds of sufferings or all kinds of fear.
虽然我们很多的就世间人可能很难接受这样的无我的道理，但是一旦你到达这种境界的时候，实际上这是很快乐的，这是很正常的。
Though it is really hard for us to adopt the notion of emptiness, of no self-grasping, and but when we have really attained or we have get to the status of this of the emptiness, it is really the bliss.
这种无我空性呢，并不是佛教它独特的一个观点，实际上它就是我们全世界的人类应该在精神领域追求的最顶峰的一个境界。
The truth of emptiness is not something special in Buddhism or some patents in Buddhism. It's the truth of all our human being, and this is the highest or the ultimate level of the truth.
因为 自古以来的历史上啊，有许许多多的具有智慧的人，经常用不同的语言来赞美无我的空性的境界。
In the history, there are many masters or there are many people with wisdom. They praise the emptiness.
我们为了到达这样的这种最高的殿堂，需要采取各种各样的方法。
In order to get into these highest realizing states, all kinds of methods would be used.
按照佛教的观点，有些时候我们会到达这种境界，或者人是无我的空性，拿一个白色的水晶球给大家看，通过这种方式来人是无我。
In the view of Buddhism, in order to get to this highest realizing status of emptiness, we always use the white crystal ball to tell us what is the emptiness.
我们有时候用沉静无垢的虚空来比喻，有时候有大海来比喻，都是人是这样的空性。
Sometimes we use the example of the vacant space, and sometimes we use the metaphor of the oceans. And all of this is to help us to recognize what is emptiness.
甚至我们可能用非常特殊的一些绘画，包括一些愤怒的像啊、慈悲的像啊等等，以种种方法、种种比喻、种种表示来认识自我。
And sometimes we use some special methods, like some pictures with in the angry status, and some pictures in the peaceful status, and all kinds of these methods are used to recognize what is emptiness.
其实我们这个世界上啊，有特别多的人，通过这样的无我的修行，自己已经到达了这个无我的这种境界，也就是说他先前了这样的证悟的智慧，这样一来他可以凭借自己的这种证悟，就能饶益就是无边无际的众生。
Actually, in our world, there are so many people have get to the realizing status of emptiness using this kind of practicing, using all methods of the practicings. And with the wisdom of emptiness, he could benefit a lot of sentient beings.
其实我们实践当中发生的各种，包括自然灾害啊，宗教的一些冲突啊，包括一些交通事故啊，疾病蔓延啊等等，各种灾难各种痛苦呢，实际上作为一个具有无我境界的人来讲呢，这些都是一种游戏。
Actually, there are many problems in our society or in our world, like somenatural disasters or some religious conflicts and some diseases, also some traffic accidents. If we have the notion or if we have realized all phenomena are empty, all of this is some kind of games or something illusionary.
最近我跟大家讲的有一个论，这部论点当中说，证悟无我空性这样的境界的话，那么一切现象都是像如梦如幻一样的。即使你处于六道轮回的话呢，好像如与 花园一样，在生活当中，心神啊、衰败啊，很多对他来讲是无女无害的，所以我们特别希望。我有时候看到，不管是哪个国家的街头啊，有熙熙攘攘、人特别多的时候，特别希望让每个人应该动到了一些新的内心的世界。
Recently, I'm teaching the Mahayana Sutra Lamkara, in this sutra, it is said that if we have realized the emptiness, we could see that all the phenomena is illusionary, and even you are in the samsara, it's like living in the garden, no matter thrived or no matter you are in the unfavored conditions, it is no harmful or beneficial to you. I think when I am in the crowded people, I really hope that all of you or some of you or most of you could understand the internal world.
最后，涅槃寂静我们人类最后到达最高的境界，也就是说是没有痛苦的一种状态，但这种状态一般的世间人很难领悟。他在不同宗教当中，有些认为是天堂，有些认为是他叫做是极乐世界，有些认为更超越的一种境界。当然这就是我们的向往的目标。
And ultimately, I will talk about the fourth Dharma seal. This is that Nirvana is the true peace, and Nirvana is the ultimate level. It is the highest level, and in this status, there is no sufferings. Maybe some ordinary people or some normal people, it is very hard for them to understand or to feel what is the feeling when you are in the Nirvana. Some people may say that the Nirvana is the heaven or it is the bliss or it is something that transcends a lot of things.
这以上呢，我就简单介绍佛教的四法印。其实佛教的四法印，如果我们明白的话，应该在你的平时的日常生活当中有一定的帮助。
And above, this is the brief introduction of the four Dharma seals. If you could understand the four Dharma seals, I think it is beneficial for your life and for your family and for your living in this society.
这样的设法印呢，是佛陀所宣说的所有的佛法的最深深的净化。也是最重要的一部法。
And the four Dharma seals, it is deepest, and it is has the essence of all the Buddha Dharma, and it is the most important teaching.
今天呢，因为我们参与的人也比较多，我按照佛教的一些道理，按照佛教的一些道理呢，也给大家念诵一些。我先跟大家念诵一些起源、和平和通达四法印的一些道理，就是先用我藏语来跟大家念一下。
And there are many participants in today's Dharma teaching.And according to the Buddha Dharma, I would chant some or give some Buddha Dharma prayers in Tibetan.
Om Jin Jin Na Jung Zang Bama Gisar Dong Bo La Yang Zang Jia Guang Ga Zhuan Ni Bama Zhang Na Ji Zi Rang Kur Dong Kwan Rang Mong Bo Kur Qi 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 Zi Dao Zhe Xun Ji La Zhe Shou Zi Zang Gara Bama Zhe Dao Hong Wa 中等的就说把这种朋友都不是做不上花的人小姐的把老乡在龙州的叫什么酒就那么他们就列雄对对对象上面送也能够把刚有把给种进步的够都把这样的下乡给我不这么做吧人个什么用心的人等上街坦白干嘛让人买没动你们是吧就是他们弄弄到真的你是就那么对的他上就三周人不去买几班的几天去几班年把没办呀公的公的陪着陪着就更多接着接着他们就都都是用等等等都不是说也蛮多的就他们拆接着去自身就拉上又不是这样老妈单班你写讲年度三毛去了学不是说就是多多能量不多多的真的这边讲做个主办单比就是多些讲人等中来用人没白拉着人等手里没白他们就像计算机都不是说这是我们佛教当中讲是种下善根也叫做呢给大家一种介绍一种善愿
and through giving these prayers is something we mentioned in Buddhism is that we plant some good seeds and we have a good relationship or good links with each other
最后我跟大家要讲一下最近呢在我们全球范围内就有各种不同的一些藏传佛教的个别的一些包括一些所谓的活佛啊所谓的藏传佛教当中的个别的一些话题呢在全世界范围当中一直也很关注
And at last, I will talk about some phenomena that there are a lot of topics about the tukus. It is some individual behavior. And these kinds of topics have spread all over the world.
不管是一些好的行为，个别人的一些好的行为，或者说个别人的一些不好的行为呢，它不能代表藏传佛教，更不能代表佛教。
There are some good behaviors of some individuals, and there are also some bad behaviors. Of some individuals, and no matter it is good or no matter it is bad, they could not be the representation of the Tibetan Buddhism or the Buddhism.
其实，从个人角度讲，有些非常好的行为，甚至非常不好的行为呢，在各个宗教当中也会有，在我们社会的各个团体当中也会有。
And from the individual aspect, the good behaviors or the bad behaviors emerges in different religions, and it emerges in different communities in our society.
但是我们在这个世界当中有一些现象呢，不能代表它的本质。也就是说，现象背后呢，也有不同的复杂的因缘。
And in our world, the phenomena could not be the representation of the truth. And behind the phenomena, there are many different causes and conditions.
因此，我们有些愿意想了解佛教，或者说是想获得藏传佛教一至三知识的人呢，不应该非常重视这个上师的图像有多么的了不起，或者说他的眷属多少多少，他的弟子多少多少，他的法祖高或者是低，这些。都不是很重要，
Thus, the people who want to know or want to learn the Buddha Dharma, especially in the Tibetan Buddha Dharma, the people who want to follow their masters, they should not emphasize the labels or the number of the disciples or if the chair of the master is high or low. These factors are not very important.
包括他的现在的所谓的 Facebook 上面的一些粉丝多不多啊，或者说他在讲课的过场面就是隆重啊，这些都是不一定有关系，这些都可以人为的操作。
And the factor of that, the number of the fans in his Facebook, or if there are many disciples when he is giving the Dharma teachings, these factors are also not important.
但更重要的，要提醒我们每个人不能迷信，一定要观察这个上师的智慧，观察这个上师的慈悲，甚至更重要的观察他的这个行为，了解这个人的一切。
Then, what is the important factor? We should alert ourselves to find or select our master with our wisdom and observe the wisdom and compassion and the behavior and everything of the master.
佛教其实一个很好的教育，我们要真正受到很好的良好的教育的话，那需要一个具有资格的老师，这样才我们的智慧能延续下去。
And Buddhism is one of the best education, and if we want to get the benefits in this kind of benefition, we should find a qualified teacher.
好，我的想说的基本上已经说完了。最后呢，特别感谢，今天是星期天，本来是每个人都可以休息，但是你们在座的人利用自己的休息时间来，我们共同学习。这也是个很好的这种机会，我也特别感谢你们。你们也许不知道有没有感谢我，没事。
Okay, what I want to say has finished. And today is Sunday. The time is very precious, and I use this precious time. And it is a great opportunity for us to share with each other. I really feel grateful for all of you. But I don't know if you had this feeling to me.
Thank you very much, Rinpoche, for your gracious teaching about the four Dharma seals. I think through this vivid lecture, everybody can not only learn Buddhist knowledge, but also understand how Buddhism views this world. More importantly, we get to know what the unchangeable truths in this changing world.
非常感谢仁波切关于四法印的亲切开示。透过这一堂生动的课程，我们相信每一个人所学到的不仅是佛教的知识，还能够真切地体会到佛教是如何看待这个世界的。更重要的是，我们可以认识到在这个无常千变的世界中，真正永恒不变的真理是怎样的。
Wonderful time always flies quickly. Thank you everyone present or on the internet. Thank you for your listening and reflecting on this topic, which I think this lecture will throw some light on your future life. Hope that one day, everyone can understand the truth that transcends all phenomena. Last but not least, although it is only early December, in advance, we want to wish you Happy New Year from Tibet Plateau. See you next year. And now let's dedicate all the merits by chanting the essence of aspirational ocean.
美好的时光总是稍纵即逝，在此我们同样要感谢在场以及网络上的听众，感谢各位的参与。相信今天的思考对您未来的生活一定会有很大的启迪和帮助，也祈愿有一天我们每一个人都能够真正的了达现象背后的真理。最后，尽管刚刚才到十二月，但我们仍然希望从遥远的青藏高原上能够给予你们对于新年的美好祝愿，祝大家新年快乐，我们明年再见。最后，让我们用愿海精髓摄持善根，普皆回向。
Sunam Dayi Dajya Rupa Nito Ne Nipa Chana Pashyaya Chikanap Chiva Lo Chubayi Chubi Chuli Chu Chuaishyo Chuyi Choro Khaji Chambuka Yila Chichi Dhanpa Chayangsu佛即用的跟你做不得等完了也来就空着做等完世界这些能我从刚给自己的纪念瓦中同你多半夜也就我写老美小姐就得得记得老舅跟你这个马多娃让多也得换了莫家吧也把蓝波三修结一对起码向我这不总结了将我跟的压机亲莫的将我换我结一结这种恨得松不满了里淡不想去修满家做大需求忙无难这个家个接着样的我做家我在多嘴老的压做年里就得起老几从里被我的多修从万里皆对我曾经能在得不值得解药得解我在东北中一路单独其中你不再记住把酒我没家的但有因得你人没做难把地花记住对个夜来漫漫的苦难同居上个望得住早起刚夜奔走的夜的满里借给你做宿舍门我心甘把这家母念不给了那位啥子家把修哎呀哎伴这个的伴马着的哦哎呀哎伴这个的伴马着的哦哎呀哎伴这个的伴马着